Gregg Bamford of REMAX Saskatoon is a high-impact volunteer for many nonprofits in his community. Greg's volunteering journey began in the early 2000s when he got involved with a local after-school program and as a coach for the Kinsmen Inner City Hockey League. He became an instrumental force behind Operation Santa, personally delivering the spirit of Christmas to families in need. From there, Gregg kicked things up a notch, organizing high-profile charity fundraisers, Wake Ride and Sask Country Showcase, and serving as an effective committee and board leader. Then, in 2018, Gregg had a life-changing experience as a participant in the Sanctum Survivor Challenge. For 36 hours, he would walk in the shoes of people experiencing homelessness in his community.
I have to admit, I thought it was a cool challenge, but I thought, it's a cakewalk. I'd be easy to be able to live on the streets for 36 hours. And then I started asking questions, I guess, after I had been asked. And I reached out to Dion Mastic Shields, which is our current executive director for Haven Family Connections. She used to work in the homeless sector. So I reached out to her and to understand why homelessness exists and a lot of the struggles that a lot of people have. Learned about trauma, sexual abuse, I guess, mental illness, and a lot of the other things that affect people to get them into the place of homelessness. So going into the challenge, I didn't sleep 2 weeks before it happened because I realized what I was going to see. I'm someone that I can't just kind of move on from things sometimes. If I've seen something and know I can make a difference, then it's kind of something that I guess I feel like I'm obligated to do.
So the Sanctum Survivor 36-Hour Challenge basically takes 10 local community leaders, Gregg being one of them, and they're stripped of everything that they have, including their clothing. So they have to choose clothing that's been donated at the beginning of the 36-Hour Challenge, down to their shoes. Gregg was partnered with a friend and colleague of mine, Alice Kuipers, and her 8-year-old son, Theo. The year that Gregg participated, we also experienced kind of torrential downpour. So it was cold, it was rainy, and then the added challenge of having an 8-year-old with them, making sure that he was fed, that he was warm, and that he had somewhere to rest.
It was very clear from the very first moment that we met that Gregg's passion lies with supporting inner city youth particularly. He talked a little bit about the work he's done with the Kinsmen Hockey League. He talked about his work with Wake Ride. And when we got to the food bank, we were given food that basically sustained us over the next 36 hours. I think both of us were shocked to see children lining up at the food bank line. Not that we didn't know that. A number of the food bank's users are children and mums and families, but actually standing in line with people who this is their everyday reality, understanding we could go home to our warm beds and a cooked meal in a very short period of time, began to make both Gregg and I very vulnerable and open to the experience that followed.
From there, we saw a lot of things that maybe I'd never seen before or thought about firsthand, being in line with kids. That was probably the biggest thing, was just seeing what a lot of kids have to deal with on a daily basis, and that probably affected me probably the most.
Gregg was inspired by his Sanctum Challenge experience and wanted to do more. He came up with the innovative idea of creating a website that would connect his community with information about local nonprofits, their programs, and their real-time needs. Gregg joined forces with his Sanctum Challenge partner, Alice Kuipers, to bring this vision to life. Informed by extensive consultations with nonprofits, Indigenous leaders, local politicians, website designers, donors, and more, Gregg and Alice created onesmallstepsk.ca. The site was launched successfully in late 2020, despite the added challenges of the COVID-19 pandemic.
He developed One Small Step as a way to try to make sure that people knew how to contribute to nonprofits, and also that people in the community knew the stories of nonprofits. Why is this work important? What difference does it make? What's the impact? And he knows that nonprofits, you know, we're nose to the grindstone, just trying to do the work on a daily basis. And we don't always have time to do that self-promotion.
Executive directors have told us that it just makes it much easier for them to be able to quickly update and share their needs with the general public so that they can get on with the work that they need to do.
Gregg has decided to take his connections to the community and utilize them in a way that promotes the work of non-for-profits in our community, but also the many barriers that exist for vulnerable populations in our community. And I think that is something that is truly commendable, especially because this isn't Gregg's world. Gregg's world is real estate.
He spends absolutely hours and hours and hours of his time volunteering because he profoundly believes that we can each of us make a change.
Making the community a better place, I get out of it way more than probably I feel like I give. So it's just rewarding.
The Canadian Real Estate Association is proud to recognize Gregg Bamford with the Canadian Realtors Care Award 2021 for his inspiring leadership and impact.